Starting on February 1st, 2022, there will be a new pricing policy for messages sent via WhatsApp Business API. WhatsApp plans to charge businesses for conversations with users. In this video, we'll bring you up to speed on everything you need to know about WhatsApp pricing policy changes. Make yourself comfortable and don't forget to like and subscribe. Let's get started. To understand how the new pricing policy works, we need to define some terminology. In particular, we need to figure out what a session is. A session, or conversation, is a 24-hour period that allows you to communicate with a subscriber. It starts when a user or a business sends the first message. Subsequent messages within a session are free. Depending on who initiates the conversation, it can be of two types. The first one is a user-initiated conversation. This means that it is a user who sends the first message, allowing you to respond to it. Each time a company replies to a subscriber within the 24-hour period, this message is still within the user-initiated conversation, meaning that it's free. A business can respond to a user's message and continue a conversation by sending non-templated messages during this period. The second type of conversation is business-initiated. In this case, you initiate a conversation by sending messages outside of a 24-hour user-initiated session. This means that it is you who contacts the user first. To send these messages, you need a template approved by Facebook. Now that we have set that straight, we can proceed to the new pricing policy itself. According to WhatsApp's new policy, businesses will be charged for sessions regardless of who initiates them. On the bright side, the first 1,000 sessions per month are free for your business. This way, you can start conversations for free, encouraging your audience to communicate with you via WhatsApp. Free tier conversations can be both business initiated and user initiated. SendPulse is an official WhatsApp business solution provider, and we don't charge you for connecting a WhatsApp chatbot or creating template messages. This means that if your incoming message traffic is not large and your total number of conversations does not exceed 1,000, then by choosing SendPulse, you can also try sending WhatsApp campaigns for absolutely free. Additionally, you will not be charged for a session if a user starts a conversation with you using call-to-action buttons on ads from WhatsApp or Facebook pages. Remember that these sessions can be started exclusively by users, and only the first session is free. You can find more information on how to set up Facebook and Instagram ads that link to WhatsApp in the description below. Now, let's talk about what you'll be charged for and how much. If you go over the 1,000 free message limit per month, then your subsequent conversations will be charged regardless of whether they are user or business initiated. The only difference is that replying to user-initiated messages will cost you less. You can respond to a user's message and continue your conversation by sending freeform, non-templated messages. However, you can only send approved templated messages to start the conversation yourself. Please note that the first templated message will cost you more than it does now, but all of the subsequent messages will not be charged until the end of the conversation. The price of the first message that starts a 24-hour session depends on your recipient's country. For example, for the USA, a business-initiated message costs 1.7 cents, while a user-initiated message costs 1.1 cents. Check out the prices for sessions in different countries in the description below. And now, the most important part, how to plan your budget. To predict whether 1,000 free messages will be enough for you to communicate with your users, go to the statistics section of your SendPulse chatbot and check the number of sessions you have per month. Let's review a few examples of conversations with users to help you get a clear understanding of how the new pricing policy works. Scenario 1. A user contacts customer support reps, communicating with them within one 24-hour session, and asks Commercial Air a question about her booking. A 24-hour session starts after the reply from Commercial Air is delivered. All subsequent messages for the next 24 hours are free in this scenario. This is an incentive for Commercial Air to respond to customers' messages faster and resolve all of their issues in one session. If Commercial Air continues to interact with the user after the 24-hour session ends, the business will have to pay to send a templated message, which will start a new session. In this case, the session will be considered business initiated and receives the information she needs in this scenario and commercial air pays for one user-initiated session. Scenario 2, a business's response to a user requires two sessions using the same template. Anne asks when her order from Barbara's Shoes will be delivered. She sends her message at 1:13 p.m. Barbara's Shoes has a chatbot that answers frequently asked questions from customers, so the customer gets an immediate response at 1:13 p.m. The next day, the chatbot sends a notification at 3:45 p.m. informing Anne that the order has been delivered. This means that a new session has started and the business needs to send a templated message. In this scenario, the shoe store pays for two sessions. User initiated, the first one from Barbara's Shoes, and business initiated, the second message from Barbara's Shoes. Scenario 3, a business sends a templated message. When the passenger's flight status changes or the flight gets canceled altogether, Commercial Air will notify its customers by sending a templated message. The first message informs Anne that the flight has been delayed by half an hour. The second message reminds her that the flight is departing in 15 minutes. In this scenario, two templated messages are sent within 24 hours, so the business only needs to pay for one business-initiated session. Scenario 4, a business-initiated session that ends within a 24-hour session. When a customer orders something from Barbara's Shoes, the company sends a confirmation message letting the customer know that the order has been received and asks if the customer wants to get future notifications. The customer agrees to receive a delivery notification, after which the company messages some additional information. In this scenario, Barbara's Shoes pays for a single business-initiated session. If the user responded after the 24-hour period, the company would have to pay for an extra session. We hope this video has helped you better understand the new WhatsApp pricing policy. If you have any questions or thoughts, let us know in the comments below. See you next time.